How's it going, people? Here I am again. Can you stand one more video? I hope you can, because I have something from the heart of God to share with you. Today I want to talk about why is God so quiet? Why is God so silent? Why isn't He telling us the things that we ask Him so much? Well, the other day I was talking to kids on the internet, and one of them said, how can I break the ice with Jesus? How can I make him answer my questions? And I answered like this: God is quiet when your Bible is like this, but if you open it, if you close it, he's quiet. If you open your Bible, he's speaking again, but if you close your Bible, he's quiet again. We have to withdraw from this thinking that we need to hear some voice from the beyond that tells us who we're going to marry, what college should we make, and how should we get money. We are so egoistic and so selfish that we are turned to ourselves so much that we do not want to hear what God has to say about all the rest. We want God to tell us only the things that have relations to us. We don't want to know about Psalms and about Jesus and about how David killed the giant and about how he's coming back in Revelations. We don't want to hear what Paul the Apostle said about the flesh, and we don't want to hear anything. We just want to know the questions for the answers for the big questions of our lives, and nothing more, nothing less. We should run away from this. We should go to hear all of God's counsel. God has a lot of things to talk to us about, and everything he wants to tell us is in this book. I've read the Bible 34 times, 34, from beginning to end. But I have read small portions thousands of times. But listen to me. Every time I read the Bible, I become a new person. And my mind opens up as to the point that I start to think like God. Because the Word of God has shaped my mind in a way that I start really having His opinions. And seeing the world like He sees. And feeling the way He feels. We are not going to hear God if we keep our Bibles closed. This is not something that we need some prophet to come and just tell us a few things and just go away. No, we need to hear what God has to tell us. This is not a pastor's job. This is every Christian's job, to read the Bible, to understand what he has for us, and to break the ice. You talk to God, good, that's called prayer. But when he talks to you, that is called Bible. Read your Bible. Everything is in here. I have received so many directions from God for specific things in my life, reading the Bible. For example, today I live in a city that has 3 million people. And I'm living here because of one verse that I read of Psalm 118. God told us to move to this town right there. Well, is the name of the town there? No. But we came to understand that that was the will of God for my family. The will of God is in here, and you have to read your Bible. Father God, I bless everybody, and I ask you to please not let us just live our lives with our Bibles closed. Allow us to open our ears and our eyes to read it. Don't let us live just waiting for some prophet to come and tell us the three things we need to hear and just go away. No, we need to hear everything your word has for every one of us. I bless everyone with the desire to read the Bible in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you know anybody who speaks English, please send this video to that person. It may be American, an English, Arabic, Japanese, doesn't matter. Just send this video to that person, Brazilian. Just send that video to that person to bless them in Jesus' mighty name. I see you next week. God bless you very much.